Hello YouTube and welcome to my fifth tutorial video on Dragon Bones. Today what I'll be talking about is IQ constraints. Now if you go look in the property or in on the website for Dragon Bones to see what IQ constraints are, they actually tell you that it's for posing bones. So if I have that one bone selected there, you'll notice on the property you'll have two little IQ constraint command sticks. The first one there is create IQ constraint at the end of the bone, another one is create IQ by pick. Now if I use the create IQ by pick once a bone is selected and I place it in, say for instance there, it'll create that little orange marker there that if I select it and move it around, it will move that bone respectively. Now looking at the domain, you can see it has an orange border, which means it actually has an IQ constraint associated to it. Now this is just a single pick there. I can add multiple ones there, say for instance on this arm and on this leg, noting that it will immediately pose my objects as I need them without having to go to individual bones and rotating them out as I also want to pose them for a specific animation. I can also pick them out all at the same time simultaneously and move them about this drawing or this area to actually pose them for myself. So that's what they say is the benefit of this, to increase the speed of posing your bones. Now this is just a simple one there. This is a one bone option. Obviously I can add the rest of them to pose them individually, but this is not the one I need to or want to use for arms and legs. Now the one I do want to show you guys has a certain limitation, so what I'm going to do is I'm just going to quickly draw out three bone structures here. Looking at that, and then once I select two of these bones, notice that IQ constraints is still visible. The one I want to show is get IQ constraint at the end of the bone. Now if I select the third one, those options will disappear and not be able to get IQ constraint at all. So having two selected is what you need, so that you can create that IQ constraint there by picking it, and immediately you'll notice that these two bones now has orange border around it, and are actually both linked to this specific point. Noting that the first bone doesn't move, it actually just rotates around its key point. The second bone actually attaches to that first bone's rotation, which is what you would expect for arm movements and leg movements. So looking at this picture here, or this bone structure here, I can create an IQ constraint on that one there. I can create an IQ constraint on this arm here. These legs, seems end of the bone first and then the first one, so there's a definite order of picking them. Just showing this to you guys here, so I have to select the end bone first and then the first bone connected to it, like that. Otherwise if I select the first bone and then the last bone, it'll automatically switch to the last bone itself, so picking it in that order is actually quite important. So as soon as I do that and I move these IQ constraints out, notice that on the properties panel there to the left on your screen, there are certain properties, like for instance the actual name, which corresponds to our scene 3 here, and I can actually go say, you know what, that is my arm right. Ooh, look at that horrible caps. Right arm. And immediately within that, it actually shows me what IQ constraint it is, making it much easier for me to select it from the scene tree instead of from picking it on the actual drawing. Because if it's on the drawing, say for instance on the body here, I might have difficulty selecting that bone if it's behind the PNG or something like that. So with this placed out, notice that if I move the body, not the actual bones of IQ constraints themselves, they automatically still target to those specific points. And as soon as they reach them, notice what happens. It actually starts bending out my bone structure, making it a lot easier for me to animate my tune or animation here or character as I walk through the process. Okay, also another thing to notice on that is once I move it in, it will bend in one direction only. So if you look at my properties there, you can see that the bend option for positive has been unticked, means it's a negative bend. If I tick that on and I move this in, we can see it bending in opposite direction. Now for the animation, it's very key to actually notice that you can only pick one side. You can't change the midway as far as I know. Maybe I should test it out a bit later in animation. But as far as I know, you can only have one direction on that. So you've got to be sure that once you use the icon constraint, that you don't need to bend in both directions during an animation. Okay, so if you enjoyed watching this video, please hit the like button. And if you would like to see more, then subscribe.